I do think nostalgically because I can remember how much I appreciated simple things. I've always aimed to have an album that sounds like it was made in the same space, so that the whole album, which is the point for us, that's primarily what we do, before we perform it or anything, before they're a collection of songs, it's an album. We really fought to make the room work, to make the environment work, because we like to think that we make records that leave you in a different place than you were when you started listening to it. That's the end game, really. Well, the music we make is not what any one of us would do. It's where our tastes meet. It's where our sensibilities and our love of music meets. So that's kind of the point of the process, really. So there's a lot of debate. We do a lot of talking. The best thing to do is to start moving. So while we're on tour, we record odds and ends in each city, in each dressing room. You've got a lot of starting points when you go into the studio. I think half of the challenge is to start, so we never stop. Like when we're on the road again, I'll be scribbling ideas and we'll be coming up with things to help the next record. We used to take a long time to describe the sound that you want in lots of very artistic language. And these days, you just confess and say, let's steal this bass sound, or let's steal this, you know, feel. It never ends up sounding the same as the thing that you're borrowing from. It's just a place to start from, and that things naturally move and change and happy accidents happen. There's less compunction about, you know, not fessing up when you're steaming.